Yo, welcome back. Today we're doing it old school, all right? We're back in the house. I haven't done a video from the house for a little while. I've been out and about in the community doing a lot of on-location stuff. Did an interview with the Price Pottinger Nutrition Foundation last week. Did some work with Paul Check Jr. from the Paul Check Live YouTube page. Man, it's been out, just getting the word out there. And those videos are going to be up real soon. They're being edited and they'll be up on the page real soon. You guys are really going to dig those. Today, though, we're talking about the three mistakes that people make when they're trying to lose weight. And there's way more than three. I mean, I can talk about 100 mistakes, but I don't have time for that, so we're just going to keep it to three. Mistake number one is we tend to gravitate toward these weight loss foods, okay, or what the companies tell us are weight loss foods. And the two that I want to talk about the most are popcorn and rice cakes. All right, people are trying to lose weight on popcorn and rice cakes. That's just not going to work. It ain't that easy, all right? And people, they gravitate toward these foods because they say, well, they're lower in calories. It'll be a good way to drop some calories out of my diet so I'll lose weight. They're lighter foods. And so if I eat lighter foods, then they're going to make me lighter. But I hate to burst your bubble, but here's what's really going down. When you puff or when you pop a grain, you're increasing the rate at which that food turns into sugar. So if you go back and you watch my Fat Loss 101 video, you're gonna find out that those foods turn into blood sugar. They crank up your blood sugar, they crank up your insulin, they make your blood sugar crash, they make you insulin resistant, and they make you store fat. So those are not weight loss foods. Rice cakes, popcorn, all those other low fat, high sugar foods are actually weight gain foods. This is why people can't take the weight off, or if they do, they only take it off temporarily, all right? So stay away from those foods. You want to eat foods that satisfy you, that keep you full for 4 to 5 hours, or even more if possible. But if you're eating popcorn and those types of foods, you're hungry almost every hour. How do you expect to lose weight when you're eating every hour, all right? So change that up. Number two, people are drastically cutting their calories. I talk to people all the time. I say, well, what is your strategy for losing weight? They say, well, I cut my calories in half. I was eating 2,500 before. Now I'm eating, 1,250. And I go, whoa, this needs to stop. All right. And the reason why is because what does your body think when you cut your calories in half? Your body thinks that there's a famine coming. All right. Your body goes into starvation mode. And so is your body going to start cranking out all this energy when it's starving, when it thinks that the famine is coming? No. Your body's going to tell your thyroid to turn down a little bit. Turn down your metabolism. So it's going to turn down your metabolism when it was probably your slow metabolism that you blamed for your weight gain in the first place. So what would be the point of that? And so this is why people lose weight temporarily. And then when they start eating food again, or when they fall off their diet, they end up heavier than they were in the first place because they slowed down their metabolism by way of dieting. You don't want to do that. And you always hear, well, the calorie is a calorie is a calorie. Well, is a calorie really a calorie? Does the law of thermodynamics really come into play when we're talking about weight loss and weight gain? Because check this out. You can take somebody on a 2,500 calorie diet and they're gaining weight. They're eating all the sugary, processed, low-fat, good-for-you foods, and they're gaining weight. Well, then you take out all of those bad weight-gain foods, and you replace those calories with quality fats, quality carbohydrates, quality protein, and they start to lose weight. But it's still 2,500 calories. So then how can a calorie really just be a calorie if that's what's happening? All right? So think about that. Thirdly and lastly, people are trying to cardio their way through weight loss. They're not changing their diet at all. They're just getting on that treadmill for an hour, hour and a half, however long, and it doesn't work. You're gonna lose weight at first, and I see this every day. I'm in the gym, people, they do their cardio, but what happens when they get sick? Or what happens when they get a lot of homework? What happens when just something comes up in their life where they can't make it to the gym? They can't come in, they can't burn their cardio, their calories. And so I've seen people who fall off their diet or their exercise program for 3 weeks and they come back to the gym looking plump. All right, what's going on there? They're slowing down their metabolism. They're not weight training. when you weight train, you put on muscle. And muscle is going to increase your metabolism. But when you're doing this long, steady cardio, you're cranking up your cortisol levels. Cortisol is a stress hormone. Cortisol is going to eat away at your muscle tissue, convert it into glucose to fuel you through your cardio. And so if you're eating away your muscle tissue, then you're slowing down your metabolism. All right. If you're slowing down your metabolism, then it's going to make you make it much easier for you to gain weight once you stop doing your cardio. This is why people stop doing cardio for, like I say, 2-3 weeks, and they come back 10, 15 pounds heavier. All right. Then they're back on it again. All right. It's like a vicious cycle. So you're slowing down. You're making yourself store fat with the rice cakes and popcorn. You're slowing down your metabolism by cutting your calories drastically. And then you're slowing down your metabolism and breaking down muscle tissue and stressing out your body by doing way too much cardio. My clients don't do any more than 20 minutes of cardio. You know, they do interval training, but they focus on weight training. They focus on putting on muscle. Because when you put on muscle, you burn more fat throughout the day. And you don't need to be on a treadmill to do that. All right? I'm out. Just some tips for you. Underground Wellness Radio is coming on real soon. We got Fred Hughes is coming on soon. He wrote a book called Am I Dead Yet? About breast cancer. Woo! Book will blow you away. Reed Davis is coming on. Paul Check Jr. I think is coming on as well. A good book. I want everybody to order. Breakthrough. Suzanne Summers. Don't laugh. Suzanne Summers knows her stuff. Seriously, people are like, oh, Chrissy Snow, she don't know anything. She knows some stuff. She's got some interviews with some great doctors on here who are doing things that work. We're going to talk a lot about hormones, okay? People are waiting on that adrenal fatigue video. It's going to blow you away because stress is making you fat. So stay tuned. I'm out. Peace.